The Complete Financial Plan, Investor's Blueprint. Hi, I'm Billy Jason Mercado of YouandImg Financial Literacy, your educator for today. You can call me Beloy for short. For more videos about financial education and financial literacy, you can visit us in YouandImg website. In this video, I will share to you the Investor's Blueprint, Saving Money, Protection, and Investment. Whether you are an investor or not, using this blueprint will help you build your financial house. For so many financial advices, paano nga ba magsisimula? In this video, ituturo ko sa inyo ang isang powerful financial concept na dapat mong sundin. This financial concept is called Solid Financial Foundation. According to the illustration, we should start at the bottom. First, you should have healthcare and protection because of the three risks in our life. You may get sick, get into accident, or even death. Kaya kailangan natin ng healthcare and life insurance. Next is eliminate our bad debts. This is obviously money is against you. We need to also build an emergency funds and if may excess money na, put in investment. Building your financial foundation is like building a house. Magsimula ka muna sa ilalim. Para mas malinaw, isa-isahin natin. Number one sa ating financial foundation is healthcare. First, ensure protection kung sakaling magkasakit. Kaya kailangan mo muna ng healthcare. Kung isa kang employee, that's good because one of the benefits given by your employer is short-term healthcare. Pwedeng Medicard, MaxiCare, and Telecare. May nagsabi, save for your long-term healthcare while you are still protected by short-term healthcare from the company that you are working. Aside from short-term healthcare, kailangan din pala natin kumuha ng long-term healthcare. Para kapag nag-resign tayo or nag-retire, meron tayong Medicard na magagamit kapag nagkasakit tayo. We should prepare for our long-term healthcare dahil hindi natin alam kung kailan tayo magkakasakit. Ngayon bata tayo? Or matanda na tayo. Tanong, is there a long-term healthcare provider here in the Philippines? Yes, meron. Kaiser is the only provider of long-term healthcare in the Philippines. According to J3 Patiño, everyone has the typical short-term plans, but no one is preparing them for the future, a time when they will no longer be covered by any company, and a time where medical and hospitalization expenses would most likely be in the millions. This is the need that Kaiser is solving, one family at a time. Others say PhilHealth is enough for me because for a 200 pesos contribution, you already have insurance. Pero alam nyo ba na di sinasagot ng PhilHealth lahat ng hospital expenses? Depende po yun sa tinatawag na case rates. Here is an example of case rates. But what if simpleng magpapa-check up ka lang or magpapa-laboratory? Wala po sa listahan ng PhilHealth yan. Next, pwede ka din naman pumunta sa mga government hospitals para makalibre. Iyon ay kung magtsatsaga kang pumila. Isa sa mga pinupuntahang hospital na mga walang pampagamot ay ang PGH. Sabi nga, how comfortable is your healthcare after age 60? Depends on your decision you make today. Depende sa kung ano ang ginawa natin ngayon habang malakas pa tayo. Depende sa kung anong ginawa nating plano. Again, if you want to learn more about Kaiser, you can check our website below. I will give you an example. If wala ka pang long-term healthcare ngayon, at ang goal mo is magkaroon ng 1 million health fund in 20 years, our solution is to start saving 6,000 a month for 7 years para ma-hit mo yung goal mo. Send us an email at youandimgservices@gmail.com or billyjasonmercado@gmail.com. If you want to request for Kaiser summary of benefits, specific for your age and goal. Number 2, sa ating financial foundation. Ensure proper protection, or yung tinatawag na life insurance. The number one reason kaya ka kukuha ng insurance is because you love your family. Protect your family from financial loss. If isa kang breadwinner, malaking kawalan sa mga dependents natin kapag namatay tayo. Lalo na kung maliliit pa yung mga anak mo. Tanong, magkano life insurance ba ang sasapat? Enough ba yung 100,000 life insurance coverage? Meron po tayong tinatawag na dime method. D is for debt, magkanong utang mo. I for income replacement. As mentioned, number one reason if bakit ka kukuha ng life insurance is to protect your family from financial loss because insurance is income protection. How much money is needed to replace your income? Ang formula po natin is insurance coverage is equals to annual income times 10. So if ang monthly income mo is 20,000 times 12 months, your annual income equals 240,000 times 10. You need 2.4 million insurance coverage. Kung ininvest ng family mo yung 2.4 million, sabihin natin kumikita ng 10% per year, ang interest income is 240,000 per year. Divided by 12 equals 20,000 passive income. Meaning, yung kinikita mo ngayon na 20,000, kung mamatay ka, kikitain pa din ng family mo kung may insurance ka. Kaya insurance is called income replacement. Then, if may mortgage ka or nakasanla kang property, isama mo din sa computation. And lastly, if may dependent child ka na magka-college pa, kailangan mo ding isama sa computation ang education fund para sa kanya. Sa estimate po natin, at least prepare 1 million education fund per child. Kung magkanong total niyan, yun dapat ang insurance coverage mo. If you are an IMG member and a Kaiser plan holder like me, may access ka sa murang life insurance na offer ng PhilAm Life. To learn more about IMG, visit youandimg website link in the description of this post or video. Example, may utang kang 100,000. Kung ang sahod mo ay 20,000 a month, you need insurance coverage na 2.4 million. Mortgage or nakasangla mong property is nasa 500,000 at meron kang isang anak, so 1 million for education fund. So the total is 4 million. You have to get protection or life insurance na may coverage na 4 million. Para may idea ka kung magkano, for example, sa age na 33 years old, nasa 13,820 lang ang premium mo for 1 year na yon to have 4 million coverage. And 1,152 per month lang kung iipunin mo for 1 year. Again, to avail this very cheap term insurance, requirement na IMG member ka at may Kaiser Savings Program. Okay, so number 3, eliminate debt. First, your decision is very important when it comes to bad debt. It is important for you to decide na huwag na dagdagan ang bad debt mo. At mag-decide ka na bayadan mo ang mga utang mo. Ilista mo lahat ng utang mo. Halimbawa, 100,000 ang current debt mo. Kailan mo gusto ma-zero out yan? For example, in 1 year. So you have to set aside fund from your income of 8,333 per month. If you can't control your debt, your income will be useless. Kasi pambayad na lang ng utang ang sasahudin mo. At kung di ka makabayad agad, palaki ng palaki ang interest. Number 4 sa ating financial foundation, create emergency fund. Emergency can happen to anyone. Kaya kailangan meron kang fund. Gaya ngayon, pandemya. Maraming nawalan ng trabaho, maraming businesses ang nagsara, nagkaroon ng lockdown. Kung wala kang emergency fund, eh mahirap. Diyan napapasok yung maling solusyon ng mangutang. Pwede rin naman na bigla kang mawalan ng trabaho, napaka-risky ng ganyan lalo na kung OFW ka. Saan ka kukuha ng pera pang gastos, pang apply ulit? So tanong, magkano ba dapat ang emergency fund? Ito ay dapat 3 to 6 months na sahod mo. Example, ang monthly income mo is 20,000 times 3 months is equals to 60,000. At least 60,000 sa savings account mo. Bakit sa savings account? Ito ay para makukuha mo agad in case kailangan mo ng pera. Make sure na hindi mo gagalawin ang pera mo sa ibang dahilan. Sir Beloy, may midnight sale sa Lazada mamaya. Pwede ko ba galawin ang emergency fund ko? Hanggang mamaya na lang kasi yung ng 12 midnight. Sayang naman. Nope, mali po yun. Dapat learn to discipline yourself para di nagagalaw ang emergency fund sa maling dahilan. Kung may 5,000 ka sa savings mo ngayon, you need to raise additional 55,000 for your emergency fund for 1 year. You need to save 4,600 a month. Next is investment. Ito na yung bubong ng financial house mo. First part is how to prepare your child educational fund. Alam niyo ba na ang tuition fee is about 30% only of total college costs? Example, ang tuition fee is 100,000. 100,000 divided by 30% equals 333,333. Estimated total education expense for 1 year. And hindi lang tayo basta mag-iipon. Dapat i-consider din natin yung 3 factors upon raising education fund. Number 1 is inflation with an average of 5% per year. Meaning tumataas po ang tuition fee at mga bilihin gaya ng school supplies. Number 2 is time. Consider also the period to save money. That's why it is important na maaga nating mapaghandaan para mas mahaba pa yung time na mag-grow ang money natin. And number 3, of course, if education fund yan na gagamitin mo pa after 10 years or 15 years, hindi po dapat sa savings account lang nakalagay yan. Find investment vehicles that have the potential to grow to outpace the inflation. So, if wala ka pang naipon o nasimulan para sa pag-aaral ng anak mo, base sa computation natin na 333,333, lumabas na you need to raise 2.4 million considering inflation rate na 5% per year. Kaya yung 333,333 ngayon is nasa around 600,000 per year na ang gastos mo after 10 years or by the time na magka-college na ang anak mo. Based on wealth calculator, you need to save 10,500 per month to hit your goal of 2.4 million. Assuming na yung investment is earning 12% per year. Kung sa bank mo lang inipon ng pera mo, you need to save 20,000 a month to reach your goal of 2.4 million. So malaking bagay talaga na naka-invest ang pera mo. Maximize the time and the potential growth of your hard-earned money. Second part of investment, if kanina you are raising fund because you love your child, now let's discuss about your retirement fund. You have to prepare for your retirement if you love yourself. The question is, how much money do you need to retire? Ang formula po natin is annual income times 20. So if your income is 20,000 a month times 12 months, your annual income is 240,000. 240,000 times 20, you need to raise 4.8 million retirement fund. So bakit ganun kalaki? Again, dapat po natin i-take consider ang 5% inflation rate on the average per year. Example, kung dati ang 100 pesos mo ay nakakabili ng 5 kilong bigas, ngayon ay nasa 2 kilo na lang ang kayang mabili ng 100 pesos mo. Magkano na kaya ang bigas pag retire ka na? So inflation means pagtaas ng bilihin. Let's assume wala ka pang savings as of now. You need to save and invest 4,800 per month in 20 years to raise 4.8 million. Kung sa bank or savings account ka lang nag-iipon, you need to raise 20,000 a month to raise 4.8 million. Okay? Okay, the lesson here, save as early as you can. Don't procrastinate or delay. Find investment vehicles that have the potential to grow to outpace inflation and achieve your purpose. And save if you love yourself because walang mag-iipon para sa'yo. To summarize what we have discussed, kung ifa-flat natin sa financial foundation mo, healthcare is 6,000 pesos, protection or life insurance is 1,152, kung may debt ka, 8,333, at emergency fund naman is 4,600. Investment, 10,500 education fund, plus 4,800 retirement fund. Initially, you need to save 35,385 pesos per month. Malaki, di ba? Nalalakihan tayo kasi di naman natin ito ginagawa ang mag-compute ng kung magkano ba dapat ang isave natin para ma-achieve natin ang financial goals natin. Kaya to build your financial goals faster, the strategy is to work on your cash flow. You have to increase your cash flow. Cash flow is not your salary. Ang cash flow is kung magkano ang natitira sa income mo after mo mabawas ang expenses mo. You may be earning 30,000 a month and your monthly expenses is 25,000. So your cash flow is only 5,000. Kaya marami ang may problema sa pera. Yung iba kasi sinasabi, basta may trabaho ako, okay na ako, basta ma-regular ako sa trabaho. Safe na ang pamilya ko. Ito kasing madalas sabihin sa atin ng mga magulang natin nung nag-aaral pa lang tayo. Pero in reality, kahit dalawa na kayong mag-asawa, nagtatrabaho, kapos pa rin. Again, the solution is to work on your cash flow when it comes to your monthly expenses. Baka sa 25,000 na gastos mo kada buwan, pwede palang 20,000 lang ipabawasan mo ang lifestyle. At ang pinaka-importante, to increase your cash flow, increase your income. Don't just rely on salary lang. Find other sources of income. Do part-time business. Do part-time job. Every weekend or use your spare time wisely. Alam nyo ba na you can do the IMG business part-time or full-time? To learn more about IMG, visit our website. I leave the link in the description of this post or video. Now, this is the last part of our video. The complete financial plan. Saving money, protection, investment. This is our investor's blueprint. Kapag sinunod mo yan, magiging matibay ang financial foundation mo. Okay, according sa computation natin kanina, you need to save 35,385 per month. Maybe you are wondering now or napapaisip kayo na parang OFW lang ata makakagawa nito or yung kumikita ng 100,000 a month. Paano naman yung iba na gusto magsimulang i-build ang kanilang financial foundation pero maliit pa lang ang kaya sa ngayon? For starters, Kaiser is our recommended savings program to jumpstart your financial foundation. Dahil Kaiser has 3-in-1 savings program, meaning may healthcare ka na, may life insurance, at may investment ka pa. Healthcare is with Kaiser itself. Life insurance is in partnership with PhilAm Life. Investment is sa Soldivo Mutual Fund. Sa mga top corporations po nakalagay ang fund. Again, visit our website to learn more about Kaiser. I leave a link in the description of this post or video. Okay, so on building your solid financial foundation, you have to build it strong. Build it right. Remember this, financial education is not just for the wealthy, it is for everyone. We are doing this in line our global campaign sa IMG, 30M by 30 Financial Literacy Campaign, which means 30 million financially literate families by year 2030. No families left behind. If may tanong kayo or other inquiries, send us a message in our Facebook page, You and IMG. Or email us at youandimgservices@gmail.com or billyjasonmercado@gmail.com. You can also comment on this post or video, tell us your thoughts about what you learned today. And of course, for more financial videos about financial literacy, check our website. I will leave a link in the description of this post or video. Okay, so thank you, God bless you all and keep safe. I will see you soon in our next video.